For some reason, I've read the Harry Potter books 36 times. Is it because I secretly have a crush on Hermione Granger? Maybe. Is it because I want Dumbledore to become my grandpa? Probably. But ever since I've read the books, I've had this dream of going to Hogwarts in real life. And now you can in this ultra-realistic video game that just came out a year ago. So I spent a bag on this game so I could play it for the next 100 hours to see if I'd actually be a good wizard in real life.
Look at this. I hooked up my Nintendo to the computer so you guys can watch what I'm doing. All right, well, the first thing we need to do is create our characters.
Customizing my character was probably one of my favorite parts of the game, because thanks to this game, I got curly hair and a British accent.
It was wonderful. I believe I'm really going to enjoy this class.
Bro, what?
I also got to name my character, don't judge.
Bro, I'm like super duper hyped for this.
I spun in near a carriage in a city where I'm about to go to Hogwarts. This is where I met Professor Fig, who's gonna be essentially guiding us throughout this entire game. And then I flew in this magical carriage to Hogwarts where a dragon attacked us in midair. Yeah, that's something you don't see every day. Professor Fig and I ended up dropping on this stranded island, and now we have to find our own way to Hogwarts. This is also where I learned my first spell. I ended up coming to this weird place in the island, and that's when I realized that I'm actually a keeper of ancient magic. And I did the first thing that anyone would do whenever they find out that they're a keeper of ancient magic. I ended up losing Professor Fig somehow throughout this entire process, and I stumbled across this really weird shaped mud puddle, and for no reason at all, I touched it. Yeah, don't touch random mud puddles. Eventually, Professor Fig and I made it back to Hogwarts, totally minding the fact that I just had a near-death experience.
Right now, I'm doing the Sorting Hat ceremony. I've been a Hufflepuff my entire life. Every test I've taken, I've been a Hufflepuff. So fingers crossed that I'm a Hufflepuff in this game.
I wonder. I detect something in you. A certain sense of... what is it?
Daring, curiosity, loyalty, and ambition. I mean, I am really curious, so I mean, like...
A desire to learn? I do enjoy a good... and I believe I have a ready mind.
Quick to learn.
Please?
Perhaps you belong in Ravenclaw.
What? This is rigged. This is rigged.
Eventually, I met Professor Weasley and she took me to my common room.
This is the entrance to the Ravenclaw common room. You must solve a riddle to enter.
Who lived longer, the ghost or the poltergeist?
A ghost or a poltergeist? A non-being can never have been.
Yeah, I'm already a natural at this. Anyways, I took a little nap at Hogwarts, and now I'm here. I'm officially a student. And now that I'm at Hogwarts, I should probably tell you my goals for this entire challenge. My goal is to become the best wizard in Hogwarts. And to achieve that, I'm gonna need to do a few things. I wanna attend flying class for the first time. I wanna pet a hippogriff and ride one, potentially. And of course, defeat all the three trials to harness my ancient magic. I spent my first day at Hogwarts looking around. I met this one student named Evray who decided to give two kids asthma right in front of my eyes. But that doesn't matter, because I'm about to go to my first class. This is where I learned my first spell, Levioso, which can make your enemies fly. Like, I wish I could have that in real life. That would be insane. But I'm about to do my first duel, which will be very interesting.
Very good, but the best way to practice is by duel. We'll start with you two.
I guess I'm going against this kid named Sebastian. Let's see how I do.
I do enjoy a life of duel. Use the baby cast when your opponent's guard is down. I put you on the spot, and you rose to the challenge. Points to Ravenclaw.
Sebastian pulled me aside and told me about this dueling club, so I immediately said, count me in. And then I went to another class where I learned Accio and Reparo. And then I decided to check out this dueling club that Sebastian was talking about. Yeah, I wanted to duel, like always. But I'm more excited for what's about to happen next. Because I'm about to go to Hogsmeade to get my wand. I met up with this girl named Natty who said,
and here we are. It is hard to know where to start.
And then I dipped. But hey, I'm heading to Ollivander's to get my wand for the very first time. Upon entering, I came across this really weird man.
Hello, sir. I'm looking for
a new wand, yes. It's about time.
I guess I'm gonna get my first one.
Well, go ahead, swish.
Well, that was disappointing. But eventually I found the right one for me, and then I went back to meet up with Natty.
I have everything. I see what you meant about not being able to pick a favorite shop.
We should walk around a bit more. Perhaps today is the day I finally pick one.
But then we got interrupted by this. Yeah, that's the first boss I'm gonna have to defeat, or else I might digitally
die.
Extraordinary introduction to Hogsmeade. I would say that we, and you in particular, have earned at least one butterbeer.
Alright, we're about to head to the Three Broomsticks where I'll try my first butterbeer. Which reminds me, because I actually have some ingredients to make some.
When I was walking to the Three Broomsticks, I overheard this goblin saying some really sus stuff.
You said you could get to the child when they came to Hogsmeade. That all you needed was a distraction. I gave you a distraction.
I just watched a student take down your distraction.
And I just realized I unlocked a side quest. Sorry, I did. It's not supposed to be dramatic.
All right, well, I got all the ingredients I need to make a butterbeer, IRL. Apparently you're supposed to get like some sort of cream soda and butterscotch syrup. They didn't have butterscotch syrup at the store, so I just got butterscotch plain. This will be a weird drink combination. Go. All right, now we're gonna open this up. Oh yeah. Okay. Yeah, it tastes good.
On hour four, I learned another spell, and then I met up with Professor Fig, who told me that I need to find this book.
I discovered an inscription. When I read it aloud, this map appeared. Clever enchantment. It's a map of Hogwarts, to be sure. But I do not know where it leads.
It leads to the library. A restricted section, to be precise.
And so I met up with Sebastian to do it undercover, even though he told me not to.
You mentioned being clever enough not to get caught in the restricted section.
And I am. Meet me outside the library tonight, and tell no one.
Soon enough, I followed Sebastian to the library. He showed me how to do the spell that makes me invisible. Like, this is crazy. Alright. Anyways, I snuck into the restricted section successfully. Dang, that was a tongue twister. And for some reason, I was led to this mysterious staircase, which finally led me to a bunch of guards that I had to defeat. And then I got to the book. I took the book back to Professor Fig, and he said,
"Some of these pages seem to be missing. It appears someone has got to the book before us. Still, I will need time to study what remains. Perhaps we can still salvage something useful, though it may take some time."
So I went to herbology class and got temporary hearing loss. I also brewed my very first potion, and even explored a little bit. And then I was led into a cave with this random ghost. Apparently this is how I get to the map chamber, which will be the main spot for the Keeper Trials. And then I almost died from spiders. Okay, that was scary. And then I found these rune symbols, which when I hit them, unlocked this mirror, which led me to more danger. I had to defeat all these soldiers, which was probably one of the hardest things I've ever attempted, but I finally got into the map chamber.
It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability
to see traces of ancient magic?
Yes, sir, I do.
But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
Well, now we have to wait for Professor Fig to come back with the book. In the meantime, I went to a class that I'm probably really excited about. This might be the highlight of the game, to be honest. That was flying class.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class.
Welcome.
The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat.
Up.
I went through a few hoops and bro, this is insane. Like, I'm freaking out. But towards the end of the class, this kid came up to me and started saying some really suspicious things. He ended up taking me on a tour of Hogwarts, which was absolutely stunning. Okay, this is crazy.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions.
On hour 12, I followed Sebastian into the secret room called the Undercroft. That's where I learned another spell, finally. And then I followed Professor Weasley to another secret room, which is where I experienced a wizarding earthquake firsthand. But this will become our home for pretty much the entirety of the game. And then I returned back to Professor Fig, who grabbed the book and then took it to the map chamber. And you won't believe what happened.
How do you do, Professor Fig? And you, my young friend. See now why you needed to return with the book? That you have come this far tells me that you possess extraordinary magical ability, the potential and power of which will unlock should you prove yourself worthy. The location of each of four trials will, in time, appear on the map. Trials that will test you and give you access to invaluable knowledge. Trials that you must complete on your own.
So now I gotta go defeat the first keeper trial.
Sup, fellow wizards. I am currently ready to go do this first trial. It will be a very big part of the game. I don't know why I think that, but I just think it will. Look at that fine little gentleman. That's me. I don't know why I said that. It's me. So, let's do this.
I flew over to this tower to meet up with Professor Fig.
Well, hello there, Professor Fig. How long have you been standing there, bro? Like,
we're not alone. We are not. Ranrock's loyalists. Around a dozen, I can see, but could be more. I suggest we investigate a little before doing anything else. Let's go.
And now I guess I'm doing this.
Stay hidden and cast Petrificus Totalus.
Yeah, I have no idea how to cast Perfeculus to... What? Wait, hold on. Google, you're not helping. So I just decided to do this instead. I don't think that's how the game intended it, but I'll just do whatever it takes at this point. Anyways, Professor Fig and I went into the tower where I found another weird looking mud puddle. But this time touching it opened up this really weird looking door. And this is where I'm going to be doing my first keeper trial. Upon entering, I came across danger right away. And instantly, I defeated the soldiers. But this is just a start. I soon went on some weird moving objects and then defeated another soldier. But that's when I went to the boss. The boss of this keeper trial, which will be the hardest thing I've ever faced in this game so far. And bro, when I say that this soldier is strong, I mean it's strong. Like, it took a solid 10 minutes to defeat this thing. But I finally defeated the first trial. Three more to go. I'm excited.
What have we here?
I'm a student at Hogwarts, sir. And this is Professor Fig.
Professor Charles Rookwood at your service. Has someone completed the first trial?
I have, Professor. Rookwood, are you able to tell me anything about the next trial?
I'm afraid it would be wise to halt the trials until we know more.
Anyways, now it's fall at Hogwarts.
Good morning. Good morning from Hogwarts. I'm still in the Ravenclaw common room. We got a lot to do today, mainly because we got some assignments to do, and today we're gonna finish this game, hopefully.
I went and did a duel, one, obviously. I learned another spell. I fought a troll. That's new. And even returned his helmet to this goblin named Lodgok. But now I'm getting to a really exciting part, because I'm about to go to Beast class.
See, you've
already met some of the many beasts we study in this class. Though be advised, none of these creatures should be taken lightly. They are all in their own way dangerous.
I brushed this creature called a puffskin. This guy's really cute, okay? I kind of want him. And then I fed this creature called a neasel. Also really cute. I want all of these pets, let's be honest. And this girl took me aside and started saying some weird stuff.
There's someone I'd like you to meet in the forest.
You've intrigued me. Very well, lead the way.
Stand back. Highwing. Isn't she just magnificent?
I want Arby's.
Go on, introduce yourself to her, but be careful. You must always show hippogriffs the proper courtesy before you approach them.
Well, isn't that romantic? I don't know why I said that, that's weird. Anyways, I fed Highwing, and honestly, this is just really cool.
That's not Arby's, you curly-headed freak.
And then Highwing dipped, like one does when they don't have Arby's. I get it, Highwing, I get it. I met up with this house elf named Deke, who taught me how to rescue creatures and release them in this beautiful wildlife area. They are just adorable, oh my goodness. But then I met up with Natty regarding something to do with Highwing.
Natty, what's going on? Why are we all the way out here?
As promised, I did some investigating to find out what Harlow is up to. I followed him to the Hog's Head. I noticed him reading a letter. All I could see was that it was signed by and bore the seal of Victor Rookwood. And after you told me that Rookwood and Harlow were after you, I decided that you were the perfect person to join me in taking them down for good.
So after getting over some walls and opening up a gate for Natty, we came across the worst thing possible.
What's that? Yeah. It's a hippogriff. No, what are you doing to it?
So I rushed up the tower and tried to save Highwing.
Highwing, it's all right. There we go.
There you are.
Come on.
Now we save Highwing from the evil goblins. You're welcome, Highwing.
Did you bring Arby's?
Okay, shut up now, Highwing.
How exciting.
It was exhilarating, wasn't it? I wasn't sure we were going to make it out alive.
There was no need to worry. I had it all under control.
On hour 30, I headed back to the map chamber to talk to Professor Fig.
I'm afraid we've no time to waste. Despite the obstacles that clearly await you, you must get to Rookwood Castle immediately. Not only is it the location of the next trial, it is home to a source of power that would be devastating in the wrong hands. I do wish we had the luxury of time. However, I do not doubt your abilities. Find my portrait there as soon as you can.
Very well, sir. I'm on my way.
So I flew over to the castle to meet up with Professor Fig.
What's going on here?
Professor Rookwood was right. The place is crawling with Victor Rookwood's lot and Ranrock's loyalists. They're working together all right, but it is not a friendly alliance. I'm sure you'll agree that we need to find a way in other than the front gate. Let's go.
As soon as we walked in, we were ambushed.
You can't stop Ranrock's rebellion!
Confringo.
But then we heard something interesting.
If I'd known your plan was to dig up half the country...
I wouldn't have to dig if you could simply manage to bring me the child.
We wouldn't need the child if you hadn't sent a dragon to retrieve the container. I spent months and countless ministry favors tracking. Have you not acquired enough power here? I allowed you to tunnel under my family home.
We had an agreement. I will share with you the power that I discovered if you locate the stores of magic that are yet to be found. So, unless you want another demonstration of my power, a power that you one day hope to wield, bring me the child.
Anyways, I headed over to get into the second Keeper trial. This will be very interesting. Okay, I'm going on to the second trial. I don't know what's to come. Man, I'm just scared.
I'm genuinely scared, but we can do this.
Upon entering the trial, I was met with a weird large mirror that when you went through it, changed your perspective. It was weird, but I finally got to move on. I was met with my first challenge, an invisible soldier. It was hard, but nothing compared to what I was about to do. Because as soon as I moved on, I was met with four of them. It took a long time, but I defeated all four of them successfully. And then I was met with the boss of the trial. It must have hated the fact that I defeated it last time, because it was so much more powerful. At some points, I thought I might have died, digitally speaking. But after around 10 minutes of fighting, I finally defeated it.
Bro, we just defeated like one of the biggest bosses in this game. Oh my goodness. I'm freaking out.
Second keeper trial complete.
You're back.
It is good to see you again.
Professor Rookwood told me about what happened at Rookwood Castle.
In light of the dire circumstances in which we find ourselves, it is most fortunate that someone so competent is following this path.
I'm ready for whatever comes next.
In that case, introductions are in order.
Allow me to introduce former Hogwarts headmistress, Neve Fitzgerald.
How do you do? I must say that I was not entirely surprised to learn that a student had been completing the trials. I am certain that you are more than capable of completing my trial. However, I must first, how shall I say, prepare the location of your next trial.
What did she just say? Prepare? Bro, how hard will this game get?
I shall confirm that everything is in order immediately.
Now it's winter at Hogwarts. I wish it was winter. I spent the next 10 hours of the challenge getting prepared for the third keeper trial. I helped save a kid from a wizarding kidnapping, which was interesting. I learned a new spell, Bombarda, and even freed a dragon. That's a long story. Anyways, on hour 30, I got a broom upgrade. On hour 33, I learned a transformation spell. And on hour 40, I visited a goblin mine where I went on the sickest elevator ride of my life. And even defeated a few foes. I like that word. That was kind of fun. So you know that weird goblin that was talking earlier in the castle? You know, the one who's been saying some sus things? Well, apparently, he's planning to put drills under Hogwarts. And now I have to stop him.
Guys, welcome back to the studio or whatever this place is called. I'm gonna be completely honest, it's been a few days since the last recording. You wanna know why? Because this game is taking too long to complete. But we're gonna get back into it and I am gonna become the best wizard in Hogwarts, alright? I'm gonna get every spell, alright? I'm gonna defeat all the four keeper trials. We're two down, okay? We got two more left, and I think we can do it.
I spent the next few hours trying to level up so I could move on to the story. I completed a Merlin trial, which happened to give me a lot of XP.
Goodness gracious, I should have just done that from the beginning.
But then I met up with our good friend Sebastian.
Why do these characters always just keep standing there? Like, I feel like that's really awkward.
Sebastian took me into another mine where I experienced a digital injury that must have hurt a lot. And then we got ambushed by giant spiders. But I defeated them. That's right. Anyways, we retrieved this weird painting that's supposed to give off a location. I don't know.
Bruh, I'm swearing. I swear, like, these levels take too long. Alright.
Welcome back.
Howdy.
Look, Professor. I have news. The goblins are looking for something. Another repository. They built drills to help with their search.
Most troubling. Fortunately, the next trial is fairly nearby.
It's Hogwarts. Is the next trial in the headmaster's office?
It is. I had hoped that when the time came, the occupant of that office would be of help to us.
Very well. I'll find some way to get in.
Well, now I have to commit identity theft against the headmaster of Hogwarts. Professor Fig gave me this really weird potion that transformed me into Professor Black, the headmaster.
Look at me. Goodness gracious. Alright.
On his way to the office, I ran into a few teachers.
Do you have a moment, Professor? I've brewed the cure for boils you wanted. I can drop it by your office when it's convenient.
But I finally made it into his office.
It's good to see you.
All thanks to Professor Fig's quick thinking. Now what?
Approach the pedestal in the antechamber and read the book that appears.
Oh, goodness. Okay. Jesus, alright.
I guess now I'm in the third trial.
Professor Fitzgerald, can you hear me?
You shall be witness to a fable. Pay attention. Things are not always as they seem.
Okay, that scared the heck out of me. But I guess we gotta move forward.
The first you will need is a cloak. In this place, as in life, death takes many forms. Avoid each of them at all costs.
What the heck?
Now I have one objective. Get past all these school people safely to move on. I don't know what they're actually called. Wait, hold on. Oh, they're called Death Shadows. Oh, that's terrifying. This is way harder than it looks. And I definitely got jump scared way too many times. But I just ran as fast as digitally possible. Eventually, I got to a point where I was surrounded by these shadows or whatever they're called. So I went into this house, which led me to this cloak. Okay. Oh my goodness gracious. Now wearing this cloak actually made me invisible. So I completed it successfully.
You have unlocked death thus far, but have yet to find me. Keep searching, but this time you will be unable to hide. Wield the wand you see before you. Do not squander its extraordinary power.
So I picked up this mysterious wand and spawned somewhere way different. And now I have a new objective. Defeat all the shadows. But this was easy since I had the most powerful wand in the game. But little did I know that it was gonna get harder. I came to a big part of the trial where I had to defeat all three of these things that I have no idea how to pronounce. It was long and tiring, but I got the hang of this wand. I even defeated this giant troll, or whatever this is, honestly. Oh boy.
You are far from finished. Pass through the mourners ahead. Nothing is what it seems.
Okay.
I can't believe she's dead.
Oh, poor Neve. Gone so young.
Let us always honor her memory.
Eventually, I came to this, grave.
You found me. But you cannot undo what has been done. The magic of the stone can only conjure a shadow of my former self. But there is no light without shadow, as there is no shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should.
Well, would you look at that? We finished the trial.
Dang. Bro, that part of the game is so cool. Alright. Oh, hello. Oh, they all appeared.
Is it true? Has someone completed the first three trials?
It is, and I have.
You are so...
young? I know. You must be Professor Bakar.
I am. I hesitate to reveal the location of my pensive to someone who, perhaps, has yet to understand the responsibility of power.
I can assure you, Professor, I do.
Nonetheless, the knowledge you shall gain after you witness my memories is too valuable to share without further consideration. I shall require time to confer with the other keepers.
Another trial complete. One more to go. I spent hour 70 rescuing a thestrial and putting them in a cute little pen. And then I met up with Sebastian for something.
I spotted droves of Ranrock's loyalists coming up from the coast.
Overheard one of them say they're headed to another cabin, like the one we found.
Should we see why the triptych led us here?
I had to defeat a few goblins, which, of course, was very easy. But then we had to defeat this large troll, which is harder than it looks. That was also very easy. We put the final painting up, which unlocked this weird fountain thingy. Anyways, on hour 80, I went to this mine, because apparently Lodgok needs something.
Lodgok, where are you, buddy?
I had to defeat a goblin, and I even went on this fun cart thing. But I was led to something crazy.
Another drill is complete. The wizarding world will rumble.
For goodness.
I can end this right now. I have to destroy the drill and stop Ranrock's loyalty.
This troll battle is the hardest battle I've ever encountered in a game. It took way too long, but eventually, I defeated it.
Bruh. What's happening? What's happening? Oh my goodness.
That is unfortunate.
Yeah, it is.
I found this lucky.
Lodgok, come to make amends, little brother.
No, Lodgok, no.
I came to stop this.
Oh, I'm scared. I'm scared. What's happening?
All this time, you knew.
You knew where it was.
Oh, no.
never understand you, Lord Gok. Gollum, that witch did not consider you an equal. She, like all wizardkind, sought only to use you.
You're wrong, Ranrok.
Young ones are especially deceitful. They are taught to hide their disgust for us as they exploit us.
You're a traitor to our kind!
What? Go, go, come on. Well, I wasn't expecting that. Now I have to finish this game, for Lodgok.
We're so close to finishing this game, is actually insane. Well, it's time to go to the map chamber. Probably for the final trial. I'm scared. Okay. Alright. Alright, am I ready to do this? Probably not, but I mean...
Professor, you received my owl. Ranrok has the last of Bragpaw's journals. He killed Lodgok to get it. He knows where the last repository is.
We need to know where the final repository is.
The next trial will involve an exceptional level of magical skill and a nuanced ability to interact with beasts.
So I flew over to this coast to start the final Keeper trial. Oh, there we go. Figured it out.
It is. I believe I know what must be done.
Do you recognize the head sculpted there?
It looks like a graphorn.
And the prints carved into the ground lead me to believe that a graphorn will somehow open the way forward.
That's what Professor Rackham meant when he spoke of my needing an ability to interact with beasts.
It would seem so. I do know that the last of a long dynasty of graphorns lives nearby. They call him the Lord of the Shore.
If that's what must be done, I'll do it.
So I guess I have to defeat this Lord of the Shore? It can't be that bad, right? I dropped in this weird part of the map where the den was.
Very well, Lord of the Shore. Show yourself.
I have a bad feeling about this. Oh my goodness gracious. Who is that?
Yeah, so that's the Lord of the Shore. One of the bosses of the game. That right there is the face of... Yeah, I'm so dead.
I'm not ready for this. Bruh.
This wasn't the only time I died. In fact, I died two more times before returning back the next day. Except I died again. This was going to be a long battle. Eventually, during attempt 7, I beat the first half of the boss battle, only to die again. So I abandoned the quest to head over to Hogsmeade to get a few potions to help me out, and returned way more confident than before. And then that's when I had the best attempt so far. The Graphorn's health was lower than I'd ever seen it before. But that all went away shortly. Yeah, so apparently the game glitched, and now there's no Lord of the Shore. Which was frustrating, seeing as I spent the last 5 hours of my life trying to beat this boss. But that all changed next attempt. I did it!
I need your help, friend.
That's right, I defeated the Lord of the Shore.
What say we pick up the pace a bit?
No need to race now, my friend.
Professor Rackham was right to have had faith in you. My memories should answer any questions you may have about the power you will need to protect.
Thank you, Professor Bakar. I shall see you back in the map chamber. The caverns below Hogwarts, where you fought Isadora. Is that the location of the final repository?
It is. You see,
We could not destroy the strands of emotion Isadora had stolen from so many. So we did all that we could to keep them safe.
Have I not proven myself, Professor? I need to get to that repository before Ranrok does.
You have, and you will. But the repository is protected by powerful ancient magic. To enter, you must craft a special wand from the four artifacts you found above our pensives.
And I must go now and craft this wand. Perhaps Mr. Ollivander will help me.
Return with the wand, and we will open the way forward.
We successfully completed all four Keeper Trials, which now leaves us with the final battle. This will be interesting.
Hello, Mr. Ollivander. I wondered if you might be able to help me with something.
I received an owl from Eleazar, Professor Fig. He was a bit cryptic. Said you need to have a special wand crafted, that you'd bring me the materials.
Yes, sir. I have them here.
I will be honest, I have never crafted a wand in this fashion. Repaired broken wands, of course, but this is something else entirely. Keeping me on my toes, aren't you? I think I can work with what you've brought me. Let me see what I can do. I should warn you, I've never seen a wand like this before. My suspicion, as Professor Fig implied in his letter, is that it serves a unique purpose. I doubt you shall find much use for it otherwise.
I understand. Thank you, sir.
Oh no. I'm afraid you're on your own. I've ensured that we have a moment to ourselves. Oh, come, come. No need for such theatrics. In light of what Ranrok now knows, you must agree that our interests are aligned.
Our interests will never be aligned.
You would let goblins take what is rightfully ours. The final repository belongs to wizard kind. We would be fools not to work together. What's that you've got there? Might this sudden visit to the Wand Maker have something to do with our mutual pursuit?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Should have known better than to try and reason with a child.
Believe it. Rookwood's reign is finally over. For now, though, I need to get back to the map chamber and tell Fig what happened. Victor Rookwood is dead. He confronted me as I left Ollivander's with the Keeper's wand.
Godric's heart. Are you alright?
He destroyed so many lives and he wouldn't have stopped. I'm glad I was able to put an end to him.
You're right. He wouldn't have stopped. You did what you had to do.
Thank you for saying so, Professor. I'm ready for what's next.
All right, then. The Keepers have been waiting.
You have completed all of our trials, and you have done so under circumstances even I did not foresee. You understand now why all of this was necessary. The portkey, the vault, the locket, the book, the trials. To ensure that one with the ability you and I share would make the same choice that Zahn, Neve, Charles, and I did. Magic that you have so carefully honed must now be used only to protect the secret we keep.
Astonishing.
That must be the way to the repository.
We can only hope that we're not too late. And that we find nothing but a repository undisturbed beyond this door.
Okay, guys, this is like the final countdown. This is scary, but I believe that we can do this. Yeah, no, I'm totally not ready for this. As soon as we entered, we came across something insane. Renrock's here. Not good.
If his loyalists are here, he cannot be far behind.
There's the area! Must be here somewhere!
Renrock and the building plane with our progress!
Let's go!
This troll fight was harder than I realized, and it took way too long. But eventually, I defeated them and moved on.
Ranrock must be getting closer to finding the repository.
I fear you're right, Professor. There's nothing we can do but keep searching.
Have somehow evaded the castle's defensive charms.
Send us this way! We shall make quick work of them!
Time to move! We're in the thick of it now.
We'll show these beasts who's in charge.
Look out! Another troll! This one's worse than the last two!
Expulsor!
Final battle. There are three phases to this battle, each one harder than the other, and I have to defeat them. The first phase to the battle was harder than I expected. Each battle from now on is gonna get more difficult. I got a lot of good attacks on Renrock and even used my ancient magic, but he was strong, like very strong. But eventually I finished the first phase of the battle. The second phase was even harder. I had to defeat these orbs to get to attacking Renrock, but Renrock had a few tricks up his sleeve. After attacking with my ancient magic, he literally shot this weird killy stuff out of his mouth. What? But even then, I finally defeated the second phase. The third phase was going to be my biggest challenge yet. Not only were there three orbs I had to defeat, but Ranrock had this crazy looking storm attack. This was going to be insane. Eventually, Ranrock came to the ground to try and attack me up close. Now, he was faster and did way more damage. I was on the verge of literally dying when the craziest thing happened. We did it. We completed Hogwarts Legacy all in 100 hours.
Congratulations. You have completed the story of Hogwarts Legacy and reached the end of your school year. We did it.
Capable.